Thank you. may take a few years, but I'm sure that by 1973 or 74...
What is that?
Something that's going to push that data point in here. Pick a name.
Pick a name? What are you talking about?
All right, I'll do it for you. McAfee. Kim McAfee. Age 15. President and Recording Secretary. Comrade Bury, Fan Club number 2748 of Sweet Apple, Ohio. Bury, would you give me Sweet Apple, Ohio, the numbers capital 7-8820, and call me right back.
Now, wait a second. What is going on here? Who is Kim, whatever her name is, anyway?
Kim McAfee, Albert, is what's going to send you back to college with the biggest hit song this business has ever seen. It's called One Last Kiss.
Never heard of it.
You haven't written it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is given by Conrad Bury on his way to the big cold army for 2 long years, and when he gives that kiss to one lucky fan chosen at random from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, it'll make Mr. Bury the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
I'm beginning to see it, Rose. We've got the record here in New York.
Take that greasy bongo playing car thief to Sweet Apple.
You let him kiss the kid?
And release the record. Albert, you'll make enough money to stay in college for the rest of your life.
Rose, it's wonderful. And I promise you, as soon as this whole thing is settled, it'll be just the two of us, in perfect bliss. I'll get a job teaching English. Blitz! Kiss, that rhymes! It'll be perfect for the song. Anybody's ever used it before. Oh, what difference does it make? It'll be great. Oh, one last kiss. It gives me so much bliss. What is your dentifrice? Oh, that's too clinical.
sure? I mean, after all. I mean, Kim, are you absolutely sure? Positive. After all, I'm 15 years old, and it's time I settled down. Doubt that you could ever be the fear. was Conrad Burby.
Smile. Please. Clear up.
better sit down.
Why? I know my sonny boy. I know he loves his mama. I know he wouldn't do anything to break his mama's heart. Go ahead, dear. What about her?
Up all men.
chosen to bestow your final kiss upon, and who will now meet us in reciting the Con Bradford in Fudge. Can that be?
Steadfast and true, to combat ready, and be united.
feet. Where is it?
In the briefcase.
Good. Bring it along. The man is almost finished up. Come on!
Thank you.
everything will be perfect. Now, if you'll just forget about the Sullivan Show for one second, there's something very important I want to tell you about you and I.
You and me, English teacher.
Rose, I'm serious. I just wanted to let you know that I'm really glad that you and I, you and me, are out here together. Being away from New York, Rose, made me see all kinds of things in a different light. That's why I wanted to let you know that I wrote Mama and told her that no matter what happens, I've decided to give up all that loot.
Albert, you did it!
Yes, I did, Rose. And I wrote her the day we left, which gives her 3 days and three nights, and so far, not a word. If you ask me, she's accepted the whole thing by now.
Kill him!
I saw
Mrs. Harry McAfee and their children Ramona and Kim are gathered to bid farewell to a typically American soldier. Ladies and gentlemen, Conrad Burton.
Like this.
be our playthings while we live. Sip from the cup of life. Mix the potion full strong and drain it to the dregs.
How do you like them apples, Mr. Peterson?
Do we need them? No, we don't. Do we want them? No, we don't. Do we leave them? No, we won't. Tell me, what did I say next? What did we ever see in them? How could we ever think that they were nice? Take it from us, we paid an awful price. It was rough from the start. Broken dates, broken nails, broken hearts.
Not until I've had my say, Rosie. I just wanted to let you know that thanks to Mama's quick thinking, Give it to me.
What's the matter with chaos today?
See?
Fidel Castro, got a guy named Napoleon Peterson who wants to talk to you.
Tell that weasley little rat I'm not here.
That proves she's there. Who else would know I'm a weasley little rat? Rose, I've got to talk to you. It's about Conrad.
And even if I were this Rose, which I am not, the one thing that would certainly make me hang up is any mention of anyone named Conrad.
Rose, you don't have to talk about Conrad. We can talk about anything you want. You, me, I, and you. Oh, Rosie. I'm sure there's nothing to worry about.
Doris, Harry, have you seen Ursula?
Ursula?
Is she missing too?
Yes, it's 10 o'clock and I look everywhere.
Mr. Peterson, Maggie, have you seen my Deborah Sue?
Or Roger? And Phyllis?
I'm sure there's nothing to worry about. They're probably all just down at the drug store. Maybe having one of them gang wars.
Gang wars!
I'm not coming home. If you want to go home, that's fine. But I cannot
triumph of a sanitation tour bound for the city dump, while her son was running around with a loser who came over looking for a good time and stayed to ruin an American woman's life. Gave up nights of rest to rub things on your chest. Nursed her savvy boy till he was born. My life has been in vain. This country's death a train. No mother, does it matter? No, a mother, does it matter? Yes, a mother, does it matter?
Conrad!
succulents grows because they prefer the